These are the original plans for a school building dating 1930. These pictures were taken in 1962. Today, 75 years on, that building is coming to the end of its life. This film is a snapshot of its past and present, before the staff and its young people are moved to a new location in Pendle. Here to greet us is the head teacher, Martin Burgess.
Hello and welcome to Edge End High School. I'm Martin Burgess, head teacher here for the past 12 years. At the present time, Edge End is in a state of flux as we move towards September 2006, when the school closes and the new Marsden Heights Community College and Pendle View College begin. During my 12 years at Edge End, there have been many changes to the accommodation, new and refurbished classrooms, dedicated computer suites, computers in every classroom, interactive whiteboards, CCTV cameras, and carpeted corridors, just to mention a few of them. The major changes, though, are not cosmetic. They are to do with the ethos of the school. We have made Edge End a community, a family where many of our pupils are second generation. Many of the staff have taught the parents of the present school role. As it says over the entrance, Edge End High School exists as a place where young people of all races and religions will find respect for themselves and their families and their traditions. And that's what we hope will continue into the future. We hope the kids that have been taught here will take some of what they've learned to create a Nelson that is one big community.
We have first moved to the exhibition hall, where we see some of last year's pupils collecting their GCSE results. An emotional time for many. And we see some of the staff who helped these pupils achieve their success. As we move around the school, many of you will be surprised to see carpeted corridors. These used to be the glass houses. Our first stop is the art room. For those of you old enough to remember, this was the geography room. I wonder if Mr. Firth's bed is still in the storeroom. We now move to another area that has seen many changes. It used to be domestic science, which of course is now called food technology. Here we see a mixture, no pun intended, of boys and girls being put through their paces. It's a pity we haven't got smell-o-vision, because the chocolate buns were already in the oven. What a lovely aroma.
Now, why would I not do that? I just
thought you could have it. We now move down the corridor to music, where we see some of the modern equipment that has been installed. The building is relatively new and will not be recognised by many of the older past pupils. Talented lot, aren't they? Now down some of the refurbished corridors to a part of the school that many of you will recognise. This is the old metalwork room. We still have some of the old lathes as well as more modern equipment, including computer-aided design. The old lathes can be seen in this snapshot from 1962. Now into Joe's favourite haunt, the foundry room. I wonder if the staff still heat up their meat pies on the furnace. And now next door to woodwork, or should I say design technology resistant materials. Remember those aprons, folks? And I still think they've got the old saws that we used to use. Do you remember the first thing you made in woodwork? More important, have you still got it in the attic? But on now to a quiet area of the school, the main corridor, with displays of the things that we do around the school. And the school badge, Menti Manibusque, with mind and hands. Now some areas of the school you will all recognise, including the old quadrangles, where the roses are still blooming. And the staff room, which used to be the library. Those old wooden tables, remember them? Well, they're still there. We now move to science. Gone are the old wooden benches. We see again the use of computers alongside the more traditional equipment. Computers are also used by the pupils to produce information for the wider community. And here we see in 1962, Nelson Secondary Technical School's move into technology. Look at those slide rules, very state of the art. The gym. We all remember the wall bars and the ropes, with Ron Cunliffe encouraging us to climb to the top. And if we listen carefully, we can hear the gentle encouragement of today's games master. Moving outside, and we see the extensive school field and that view beyond to Pendle. Yeah, worth going out on a cold, wet Monday morning, dressed in t-shirts and shorts, isn't it? And again to the library. This also is an extension to the original buildings, and many old pupils will certainly not recognise this at all. But it's a very well-stocked learning and resource centre that is used by many of the pupils every day. Finally, to the school hall, where we see a play rehearsal, keeping up that long tradition of school productions too numerous to mention. And it's now that we draw the curtain and say a final farewell to Edge End High School.